Okay, let's get some of the housekeeping details done here. MSU Extension receives a portion of their funding from the federal government, and as such, we comply with many federal rules. MSU is an affirmative action, equal opportunity employer, and Michigan Extension programs and materials are open to all, regardless of race, color, national origin, sex, gender, gender identity, religion, height, weight, age, disability, political beliefs, sexual orientation, marital status, family status, or veteran status. And if you feel that you've been, if that's not true in your case, please let someone know and put you in touch with people that you need to complain to. Having been through two civil rights audits in my 27-year career, I do have to demonstrate that this statement is true. So we're going to begin here in a little bit. Check your audio. If you haven't done that yet, if you can't hear anything, you can check the audio settings. And during the webinar, if you can't hear audio and you can't figure out what's wrong, call the help desk. And the help desk number is between the on the left side, pardon me, on the right side in the middle. If you have any questions during the seminar, there are two buttons. The chat button is disabled. If you need to ask questions, you need to use the ask question, the Q&A icon, and you can type that question in, and then we'll either answer it quickly or at the end of the session. So today we're gonna do late season weeds management with Dr. Sushila Chaudhry, and we're going to do insect pests with Rufus Isaacs tomorrow, and then Catherine East will do grape rootstocks on Friday. These sessions will be recorded, be available on request. As you're viewing the session, a survey will open up after the session, so please fill it out. We need the numbers for impact surveys that we do to justify our programming. There are no RUP credits for this session. And I wanted to mention also that they're doing a small fruits and hops survey. And so this is a census of the grape and small fruit and hop plantings in Michigan. And we do that with funding from the Michigan State Hort Society. And it helps us understand what the research needs are. And by showing the size and diversity of the industry, we can help secure grant funding, make planning decisions on what we're going to do research on, or growers might make those, and developing programs. So if you haven't filled out that survey, please do so. And so now we're going to start with an introduction to Dr. Chaudhry. And she was born in India, in Rajasthan, got her bachelor's degree from the Punjab Agricultural University, her master's from the University of Florida, and her PhD from North Carolina State. And she's done postgraduate work at both North Carolina State and Kansas State University before she came here. She'll now be in charge of the fruit and vegetable specialty crop herbicide programs, and I'm looking forward to working with her. We should get a video starting here pretty quickly with an introduction of her actually in the field.
Thank you. Hello, everyone. I'm Sushila Chaudhary, and good afternoon. Today, I'm going to present on mid-season weed management in vineyard. And I started this position in this January, so I'm very excited to work in the wine crops. So I have divided my presentation in these four different groups. So first, I will talk about that why it's important to manage weed in vineyards. Then I will talk about the more important points that we need to keep in mind when we are designing a weed management program in vineyard. Then I will talk about the what are the options that we have to manage the weeds in mid-season. And then I will talk about the reasons that why sometimes we don't get the appropriate amount of weed control that we expect. So before I will go further in my presentation, I just want to say that I have used several different herbicide product name in this presentation. That is just to identify that product. It's not for endorsement of any specific product. And as always, we know that label is the law. So please follow the label if you find any disregarding information that I'm presenting in this presentation. So as we know that weeds are important to manage in grape crop, as they are important to manage in any another crop production system, because they can compete for water, nutrient, and light for the vine. And they can also reduce the fruit quality as well as fruit yield. Especially weed management is very important in grapes when we start planting them in the field. So especially for initial 1 to 3 years, it's very important that weeds should be managed in proper way so that those small vine, they get chance to establish in the field for the production. And later in the years, when vines established really well, that at that time, the weeds can also interfere for harvesting as well as other cultural management practices that we are going to use in the vineyard. For example, application of any fungicide or insecticide. So that can also be disturbed by the presence of the weeds. And then these weeds can be an alternative host for pathogen nematodes and insect, as well as to vertebrate pests. So that's why it's very important to manage these weeds in our vineyard. So for weed management, there are several non-chemical methods are also available that can be used. But each of these methods has their own pros and cons. So, and all of the methods cannot be used in one of the vineyards. So based on the vineyard location, soil type, and size of the vineyard, you can pick one of the management tool and use in your vineyard. For example, hand weeding. It's very difficult to do a hand weeding in a big commercial vineyard because it is very expensive and it's very time consuming. However, in some cases, like if there is a heavy infestation of wild grape or heavy infestation of poison ivy, then sometimes we don't have any other option other than doing the hand weeding. So in that case, it's a really good tool to manage the weeds. And mowing is another tool. So mowing can be good in the vineyard because it can increase the organic matter, and also it has the negative point also, because too much mowing in vineyard can compact the soil, and then that can also restrict the root growth. So like this, all of these techniques have their pros and cons. So I won't spend much time on these techniques, because on this presentation, I'm going to talk mainly about the herbicide that we use for managing the weeds in commercial vineyards. So the information that I'm going to present during this presentation, I have got from the Michigan Fruit Management. You can get it from the Michigan Fruit Management Guide. So there are the few important points that I would like to talk for designing an effective weed management for any vineyard. So, and about each of these topic, I will talk in detail. So the first one is the correct identification of weed. So before thinking about any weed management program in your vineyard, the first step is to identify the weed, as well as to make a proper guide that what kind of the weed are present in your vineyard, and in which location in the vineyard is heavily infested with the weed. Is it perennial weed or it's a annual weed? So there are several different tools that can be used for proper identification. Several books are available. I really like this North Central book for identifying the weeds, as well as there are some apps are also available. For example, this one is developed by University of Missouri for identification of weeds. And then as always, you are more than welcome to submit the samples to the, any of the personnel who work at Michigan State University. We are always happy to help you for correct identification. So based on the weeds can be characterized based on their life cycle. There can be annual, they can be biennial, and they can be perennial. So the annual weeds are those they can complete their life cycle within a year. So in case of the annual weeds, it's very important that we reduce their seeds production, because that's the way we can reduce this amount of the seeds that are present in the soil seed bank. So it's very important that if there is an annual weed, those are mainly issue in your vineyard, then you are controlling those weeds before they even set the seeds, so that for following year there won't be much weed pressure. And the other type of weeds are biennial. So these are the weeds, they grow most of the time in fall, and then over winter and in the following season they start producing the seeds and complete their life cycle. And another type is perennial weed. Perennial weed grow year by year, and they reproduce through seeds as well as the vegetative underground plant parts such as rhizome and stolon. So perennial weeds are always hard to control if they have established in your vineyard. So it's always good to manage these perennial weeds as soon as you see them in small patches in your vineyard, because then they are easy to manage as compared to when these weeds get, your vineyard get heavily infested with these perennial weeds. Weeds can also be identified, categorized based on their morphology. So these are grassy weed versus broadleaf weed. So it's very important to have identification of grasses and broadleaf, because there are some product that can only work for grasses. For example, post and fusillade that is used in our vineyard for managing the grass weeds. So once we have identified our problematic weed in vineyard, then the second step is to select the herbicide. And herbicide selection can be done based on their application method, that how we are applying those in the field. Some herbicide have pre-emergence activities, so these should be applied on the soil, and they can only control the weeds those are emerging. They do not have any activity on already emerged weed. And they can provide control up to 6 to 8 weeks, depending upon the type of herbicide. And it's also good to have a tank mix of pre- and post-emergence herbicide together to broaden your weed spectrum, control of the weed spectrum. And then the post-emergence herbicide, they are applied through the foliage and they control the already emerged weed. And based on their activity, they can be contact type and they can be systemic type. So contact type of post-emergence herbicide such as Rely, are Gramexon and AIM. These are the contact type of herbicide. So they only kill the plant part that they are come in contact, like the foliage. And the systemic type of herbicide is like glyphosate. So it can absorb through the leaf and then it can translocate it through the underground plant parts as well, such as root and rhizome. So they can provide a good control of weeds, especially in case of the perennial weed, because we would like to kill those underground plant parts for effective weed management. And then weed herbicides can be select based on their selectivity. So some herbicide products are more selective, so they can only control some specific type of weed species rather than all different kind of weeds. So for example, I earlier mentioned also that fusillade and post, they are the grass herbicide. So they can only have activity for the grasses. They do not have any activity for the broadleaf weeds. And some products are non-selective, so they control a wide range of weed species. For example, glyphosate, Rely, and AIM. And the another way we can select the herbicide is based on the mechanism of action. So the mechanism of action is the way that how each herbicide is interacting in plant and how they are affecting a particular mechanism in the plant, so that after that plant cannot grow normally and it starts showing the injury symptoms. So it is very important that we select herbicide upon the mechanism of resistance, because to manage our herbicide resistance weeds. Because if we are not rotating our herbicide and using same herbicide each year, then herbicide resistant weeds started to come in our vineyard, and then we will have the high number of herbicide resistant weeds in the vineyard. So it's very important to rotate your chemistry each year. So this is the list of the herbicide that are used in vineyard for pre-emergence. And we have a wide range of herbicide that comes from different, at least from 9 mode of mechanism of actions of growth. So Surflan, Prol, Salicom, Trellis, and Aleon, Casaron, and Carb, they have only pre-emergence activity. But the herbicide that comes from group 5, 14, and 2, they have activity for both pre as well as the post. And then these are the herbicide that can be used in vineyard for post-emergence. So Rely, Grimexon, AIM, and Venue, they have the contact activity. And the systemic one is Roundup, Post, and Fusilade. So I mentioned a lot of name of the herbicide, and then so the thing is, like, from where you can get the good amount of information about each product, because each herbicide is unique and there is some specification that you need to know before use of that herbicide. So the best place you can find that information is Michigan Fruit Management Guide. There are several tables are prepared in that guide that can show you the name of the chemical, their rate, and then specific remarks about that product. So for example, Diuron, it cannot be used if vineyard is less than 3 years old. And it's recommended to use the low rate of Diuron if vineyard is in sandy soil. And then in this book, there is some table that shows that the activity of each herbicide with respect to the weed species. So for example, Aleon has a really good activity for most of the annual broadleaf weeds, those are mentioned here, as well as for the annual grasses also. And it has some activity for perennial weed, such as plantain and sandbore and vetches. So this table can give you a really good information and help you for selection of your herbicide when you have a particular kind of weed problems in your vineyard. And label is always recommended to read before you are going to apply any product in your vineyard for detailed information. And then you can always contact to MSU personnel or talk to your chemical sales representative for more information about any of the herbicide product. So now I just want to talk about few of the factors that can influence the efficacy of the pre-emergence herbicide. So as I mentioned earlier also, that these herbicides should be applied on the soil surface. So the presence of any vegetation or crop residue can reduce their efficacy. So if you see that your vineyard is heavily infested with the weed and they are actively growing, so before application of any pre-emergence herbicide, always do a post-emergence application with Grimexon, AIM, or glyphosate to control already growing plants, and then apply your pre-emergence herbicide. Or if there is a very, you see that only few weeds are growing, then you can do a tank mix of pre- and post-emergence herbicide that can provide you a control of already emerged weed and then the emerging weed. Soil moisture. Soil moisture is also very critical in case of the pre-emergence herbicide, for activation of the pre-emergence herbicide. Because at least there should be a rain or irrigation event within 1 or 2 weeks of application of pre-emergence herbicide for their activation. And then always play soil texture and organic matter always play a very important role when we are selecting the pre-emergence herbicide rates. Because if the vineyard is in the soil that has more clay content or higher organic matter, then there will be a more absorption of those herbicides. So then you will need a higher rate of those products. But if they are in the light and sandy soil, in that case, you will need a lower rate of those products. So each herbicide label has that information that if the efficacy of that herbicide is going to impact by the soil texture. So for example, in case of Aleon, if the soil organic matter is less than one, then the rates vary from 3.5 to 5 fluid ounces. But if the soil organic content is higher, then rate can go 5 fluid ounces per year. And this information can also be obtained from the tables that are present in Michigan Fruit Management Guide. And each of these products says that, for example, Diuron, Simazine, they need to use the lower rate when you are using in the sandy soil. And the application timing for pre-emergence herbicide is, I'm mentioning again and again, when there is no weed present. So that's the best time to apply your herbicide. So the best time for pre-emergence is early in the spring. So in that way, they can give you 3 to 8 week of residual activity. And then the another application can be made during the mid-season or in the fall after the harvest. So these are the fact. Now I will talk about the factors that can affect the efficacy of post-emergence herbicide. So the application timing is very important in case of the post-emergence herbicide, especially if there is a lot of annual weeds, then herbicide application should be made when those weeds are 3 to 5 inch tall. So we call them is like follow the pop can rule. So it means that when your weeds are approximate a height of your Coke can, then the herbicide should be applied. If you are going to wait till later, then weeds will grow big and then herbicide won't give the appropriate amount of control. And in case of perennial weed, it's always important to apply late summer or early fall application, because this is the time when perennial plants are sending their carbohydrate towards the underground plant part, such as rhizome or crown or roots. So if you are making application at that time, then those herbicides will also translocate to the underground plant parts along with the carbohydrates. And efficacy can reduce if weeds are under any stress, and then appropriate adjuvant should also include in the tank mix for increasing the efficacy. And then it's very important to have good coverage in case of the contact herbicide, especially for AIM and Gramoxone or Rely. And then the weather condition also has a very impact on, such as temperature or soil moisture for their efficacy. So now I'm switching gear and going to talk about the mid-season weed control options that we have in the vineyard. So this is a really nice graph that is developed by Dr. Pohl from Cornell University, in which they are showing on y-axis is the rate of the growth of each organ in grapes, and on x-axis there is a time. So based on this graph, they are showing that period when weeds are present from bloom through varizon, that is the time when weeds can cause a reduction in yield. However, right now we are in the stage of varizon to harvest in most of the grape production productions vineyard that are here in Michigan. So this timing is the time when weed might not affect the yield, but they can significantly reduce the harvest efficacy. Because if the weeds are present, it's very hard to do the harvesting, and then the berries can be contaminated with the weed seed or weed debris. So that's why it's important to have the weed control at this time. And also to reduce the seeds in the soil seed bank for next year, because weeds right now can be setting up the seeds. So it's important to control them now so that there won't be a much seeds in the soil for next year. However, there are very limited options that we can be used in the grape right now for managing the weeds. And that because there are label restriction for use of most of those herbicide, for example, in case of the gold tander. It can only be used when the vine is at dormant stage. So they can be used in fall or before the bud break in spring. And similarly, it's like Princeps, Cinivar or Salicon also. They can be used in fall or spring before the weed growth start beginning. So this is one of the limitation. That's why we cannot use a lot of pre-emergence herbicide during the season, because they have this restriction in terms of application timing. And the other restriction we have at this time is to selection of herbicide based on their pre-harvest interval. Because some of the product have a really long pre-harvest interval, so they cannot be used at this time of the year when for the weed management. For example, this trellis, it has a 60 days of pre-harvest interval. So we need to make sure that whenever we are making application, we plan accordingly that we are not reaching to the 60 days for the harvesting. So these are the herbicide products that can be used during the mid-season for weed management in vineyard. So for example, Joe's Prime, it has only 3 days of PHI. It can be tank mixed with Gramaxone, AIM, or Venu. Roundup is also can be used, but it's more risky to use Roundup as you are going in the growing season, because it can cause a significant amount of injury, not only this season, but in the following season. If a proper care is not care is not maintained. So this is a injury that was observed from paraquat. So paraquat generally cause these spots on the leaf, but you can see that it moved through the veins also. So the reason is because this application must have been made in the evening, and then because under the dark condition, paraquat doesn't get activated, it start moving within the plant. And then when the next day the sunlight will come, then it start activating and it start killing the plant cells. So that's why you see some of the little bit of movement of paraquat in grapevine when you make the application, and after that there is a dark period. And these are the injury of the from glyphosate. So glyphosate can cause these puckering of the leaves, and then small leaves as well as these yellow colors. And sometimes it can also cause lots of branching on the grapes. So the one thing is, like, at this time of the year, whenever you are making application, you need to be very cautious that the herbicide product is not touching to the actively growing plant part of a grape vine, because that can cause the injuries. So I just want to talk a little bit about the vine beet control project that we are doing during this summer. And we have tested several products that I would like to show in this presentation. So this study was conducted in Concord cultivar that was planted in 1967 here in East Lansing. And during the springtime, this vineyard got a blanket application of glyphosate, Carmex, and Davernol. And in the following, herbicides were applied in the summer on June 10th. So this is the list of the treatment that we have applied. We used Roundup, Rely Plus Venu, Gramaxone, Quinstar, Embed, Stinger, and Juice Prime. So I would like to mention one thing, that Quinstar, Embed Extra, and Stinger, these are not registered to use in grapes, because they can cause a significant of injury if they used with no proper care or timing. So these are the pictures that I have taken from my study. These are after 4 weeks after treatment. I would say they are taken in mid-July. So you can see the weed pressure that we have in non-treated plot. And then this is the plot that was treated with Roundup. And Roundup did a really good job for managing the field bindweed. All these dead plant tissue that you see, most of them is field bindweed. Relay, I would say it just suppressed the field bindweed, because it's a contact type of herbicide, so it just only killed only the plant those were present at that time, at the time of application. But then more plants grow as season progress. And Relay plus Venue, addition of Venue improved the weed control in the plots, and we saw more control of other weeds along with the field bindweed. But still, you can see a lot of regrowth is started. Similar story with Gramexone, a very minute suppression that we saw, but then again it started growing a lot of field bindweed, you can see here. The product, Juice Prime, it worked really well for controlling the field bindweed. It's, I think, hard to see here, but there is a lot of dead field bindweed that you can see. But it does not have any activity on the Canada thistle. So that's why it's most of the plant that we see is Canada thistle here. So the another product that we tested is Embed Extra. And it also worked really well for controlling the field bindweed. So all these brown dead tissue that you see, it's the field bindweed. And up to 4 weeks after treatment, I haven't seen any regrowth of field bindweed that is happening in the plots treated with Embed Extra. Stinger, on the other side, it's also a group 4 herbicide, but does not have any activity for field bindweed. However, it worked really well for controlling the Canada thistle. So that's good. From these two plots, I have also observed the typical auxin type of injuries, you know, the cupping of the leaves from Embed Extra as well as from Stinger. So I'm looking forward for their changing their application timing. So maybe the fall application timing can provide us better control and won't show us these injury to the plant. So yeah, this is something that I'm looking forward to do in future. But from this study, we find out that glyphosate and Juice Prime, as well as Embed Extra, they provided a good control of field bindweed. Now I will just take a few more minutes to explain that what are the some reasons that we don't see a good weed management, weed control in our vineyard. So the first thing is, it could be that the wrong identification of the weed, because as I mentioned that some of the product can, like, not all of the weeds can be controlled with one or few herbicides. So each herbicide has their own weed spectrum. And then the wrong selection of herbicide, because if there are a more grassy weed problem in your vineyard, then Salicomprol and Sulfland, the pre-application of these herbicides would be good. However, if the broadleaf are more issue, then Simazone, Gol, and Carmex would work better. So if for some reason the herbicide selection is wrong, that could be also the reason that you didn't have good amount of weed control. Another thing is unfavorable weather conditions, especially when we are making application in spring, and if temperature is too low, then the efficacy of post-emergence herbicide wouldn't be that good. And then incorrect application timing, weeds are too big or weeds are under stress when we are applying the herbicide, or in case of the post herbicide, that could be the reason for the failure of the weed control. And then the other reasons could be the application error, or the, you know, the sprayer was not properly calibrated, or while you are applying, then there might be a nozzle that is clogged. So therefore you are not getting the good coverage. So these are the some of the reason that could be the possible potential reason for your lower weed control from these herbicide applications. So once you analyze all of these factors and you see that, no, you did everything right, still you are not able to manage the weed, then we think that it might be because of the herbicide resistance, that you are using that product for very long time and now the weeds are evolved their resistance. So that's why we are not able to control that. So with that, I'm concluding my presentation and I'm more than happy to take any question. I hope I didn't go too long.
Here we got a question already. So the question reads, do weeds have an allopathic effect? Do they release some compounds into the soil that we can detect in the wine?
That's a very tricky question. Yeah, like some plants do have an allelopathic effect, but I'm not sure that is it possible to detect that allelopathic effect in the grape wine. So, yeah, for example, like I know that if you have the cereal rye or if you have, that can produce some allelopathic impact, a compound that can cause some inhibition of other plant growth. But I haven't seen any particular weed that is causing any kind of allelopathic effect to grapevine. Maybe I don't know, Mark, if you have anything you want to
add. I haven't
add.
Seen any research, I would think that, radishes come to mind as maybe the only thing that might be, mustards might be the only thing that you might be able to pick it up because of the, but those are the only ones I can think of. Mm-hmm. Mustards are pretty easily controlled with a pre-emergence. Mm-hmm. Are there any other questions? What role does mechanical weed control have in herbicide resistance management? And then wanted to know about optimum timing. So they're talking about tillage with resistant weeds.
Mm-hmm. So obviously it's better to incorporate multiple techniques in your weed management toolkit. Because the thing is, like, if you are doing a cultivation in your vineyard, so it's not always possible to do the cultivation in vineyard because the roots of grapes are very shallow. So if you are doing too much cultivation, then you can injure those roots. Then the wine growth can be impacted.
Okay. All of a sudden we got a whole bunch of questions here. So they're asking for your recommendation to control nut's edge that's been spreading in the vineyard for years.
Mm-hmm. So for nut's edge, they can use Casarone as a pre-emergence product in spring. It's a herbicide that can be used in spring, and that can give a good control of nut's edge. And then glyphosate is also another one that has some activity on nut's edge. So yeah, this is one of the difficult weeds to control actually. Once it's established really well, because there are only very few products that can be used in grapes. So top of my head, the one product coming is Casarone that can be used in spring.
Okay, then there's another question here on bindweed, and they're asking if the bindweed's prevalent in the vineyard, and she's talking about between the rows, will keeping the bloom mode help with control? So she's asking if mowing off the flowers will help control the growth of the plant.
So bindweed is a perennial weed. So it can grow through the seeds as well as through the underground roots. So definitely if you are mowing that, then it will kind of giving that plant under stress, because you are, as long as plant is growing and you are mowing them, so you are giving the plants under stress. So it's good. And also when you are mowing the plant, then you are removing the seed, flowers that will eventually produce the seed. So yes, mowing can be a good option, but it should be done in a regular basis, not like just only one or two mowing will provide or give you enough control of field bindweed.
Mm-hmm. It's a pretty frustrating weed to control.
Yeah.
Yeah. And we have... Mm-hmm. Then we have one more question from the person who asked about mechanical tillage for herbicide resistance. Also wanted mm-hmm. to know about burning the weeds using propane burners.
Yeah, so the herbicide resistant weeds are, it doesn't mean that they are resistant to any of the mechanical or, you know, the burner that we are using. Yes, we can control them through those. But the thing is, like, for example, if you want to use the burner, so then you need to target those weeds when they are like really small, because otherwise it's very difficult to burn, you know, the big weeds.
So yeah, the fire hazard.
Yeah, and so the my message is that yes, you can control the resistant weed by using other non-chemical techniques, because they are not resistant to those non-chemical techniques. Yeah.
All right, one more. Person's asking about control, post-emergent control of horseweed or mare's tail or a Canadian fleabane, and they've used diuron as a pre, mm-hmm. but they want to know how to control it post-emergent.
So, in case of the horseweed, it's always good if you have a horseweed, then you make a fall application of post-emergence herbicide, like glyphosate is the good one that you can use, because that fall application, it can help to control the horseweed plants. Those are germinating in the winter. So then in spring, you will have less weed pressure, like less pressure of horseweed.
Yeah, and can I add to that?
Yes, please. Yeah.
If you, mm-hmm. it's relatively easy to kill horseweed if it's still small in the rosette, but once it starts to bolt and get taller, it becomes pretty hard to kill it. And in order, one trick that grape growers use down here in the Southwest is they'll mix AIM in with Roundup, and they try very hard to get it onto the growing point of the shoot as it's shooting up. And if they don't get that done, their control fails. But if they can get that done, 9 times out of 10, they can kill that weed.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But once it gets up higher than the spray pattern, it's pretty hard to do anything other than just burn the leaves off the bottom. Mm-hmm. Are there any other questions?
Thank you for the comment, Mark. Yeah.
All right. Well, many of you should have had a questionnaire pop up in one of your browser windows to fill out after this is over. And then we'll be doing this again tomorrow at noon. Dr. Rufus Isaacs will be speaking on insect control, late season insect control in the vineyard. So hope to see you all then.